Wait, didn't I mention here that we met the queen of the sea herself? Well, let me get Jenny to explain you what this feels like.
So we use shakers underwater. So as soon as you hear the shaker, you do know there's a whale shark. So immediately when I heard the shaker, I was looking around where the whale shark is and I couldn't see it because we are usually with the back to the rocks and looking out to the blue where it is. And I saw the divers coming towards me, so I didn't really realize what's going on until I turned around and basically looked her directly in the eye. And in this moment, I think I forgot everything. It's just, wow. When you have a huge animal like this swimming by you, it was calming on the one hand, but totally speechless. I mean, I didn't forget everything what I had to do underwater. It just was looking and wow. It is just for everyone a different moment, obviously, but it's very, very unique.
What is she feeling? What is going through her mind? What has she experienced in her life? How is she sensing her environment? Is she as interested in us as we are in her? Questions which answers will be going beyond our human expectation and understanding.
My favorite is the whale shark. To dive with that giant is one of the most amazing experiences that you have in your life, I think.
We are studying whale sharks, which is a species that is still not that much known about. So we have a very unique population in the Galapagos Islands. So we have nearly 100% females and adult females, which are not as well studied as other parts of whale sharks, like young males, for example. So we still don't know where they give birth, we don't know where they're mating, so it's still a lot of things unknown about whale sharks.
It's a massive privilege for me to be able to work with these adult females here in the Galapagos. So working with whale sharks is quite difficult because as they become adults, they seem to move away from the coast. So most of the work on adults has to be in the open ocean. So we're kind of looking for places like Darwin Island, these volcanic islands or seamounts way offshore in very remote areas, and that's the only place we can really consistently find them.
Whale sharks can get quite big, so the discussion is still how big they get. We'd say it's around 16 to 18 meters. However, there are also reports from other countries where there are sightings up to 20 meters. Incredible facts about whale sharks.
I guess one of my favorite facts about the whale sharks that it's kind of because we don't understand it very well, but they're the deepest diving of all fish. We've tracked them down to over 1900 meters from the surface, and that's partly just because we're limited to how deep our tags can go without getting crushed by the pressure. So they're making these incredible deep dives, and we're not quite sure might have something to do with navigating the using the Earth's magnetism, and they can kind of detect it better at depth. But yeah, that's one that really interests me.
The danger with diving with whale sharks, I think there are not many if you respect the animal, the distance, their filter features, so there are no harm for you as a diver. However, many divers are obviously forgetting everything around them when they're diving with whale sharks. So a whale shark, if they're just gliding down, they do it very slowly, going deeper and deeper and deeper. So if you as a diver don't watch your limits, like your depth, then it can be harmful for you as a diver.
So I think the most important outcome of our research in Galapagos so far has been understanding a lot more about the movement patterns of the adult whale sharks. So we know now that they are an open ocean species. As they become older, like, they don't really come onto the continental shelf anymore. So they're really out in deep water. And where that's really helped us conservation-wise is that we've been able to show some of their sort of movement paths and where they overlap with fisheries and things. So that's helped lead to the Galapagos Marine Reserve being expanded, and also a protected zone, a swimway, created between the Galapagos National Park and Cocos Island, which is another World Heritage Area and a really important kind of pathway for whale sharks, silky sharks, hammerheads, all these other amazing species that share this environment.
And how is it for me? How is it for me to be swimming next to one of the biggest fish in the ocean? Next to an animal much older, wiser, and powerful than me? It is indescribable, with no comparison in size and aura, but such gentleness and grace, like the queen of the sea herself. The way this ocean giant is almost non-reactive towards you, though it might be the first time she sees a human. With one simple move, she could do your critical harm, but there's nothing but respect. And the eye contact with her is something that you will never forget. The spiritual connection that you can achieve just by a look in each other's eye is enlightening, although we are so different. One is human and one is fish. There is still a soul in the eye. One is human, one is fish. So does it matter? We have to think outside of boundaries, which are all conventions, to be able to achieve incredible things. We have to think in new ways, in new orders. Cutting yourself from others is not the way the world works, no matter from human or any other living being. To be able to sustain yourself in a healthy manner, it is crucial to venture new ways, to think new, and think and act together. Because the alignments are going beyond our own environment and impacts everything and everyone around us, in space and time. Consciousness and awareness are the keys in which way everything can act together as a whole again and restore the pieces that have been shattered to create the world we are craving for.